Distinguished future physicians, welcome to Stomp on Step 1, the only free video series that helps you study more efficiently by focusing on the highest yield material. I'm Brian McDaniel, and I will be your guide on this journey through schizophrenia and other psychotic disorders like schizoaffective, delusional disorder, and schizophreniform disorder. This is the second video in my playlist covering psychiatry. Psychosis is disorganized thoughts and a distorted perception of reality. Psychotic individuals will usually have a loss of function and a lack of insight, meaning they don't realize their perception of reality is distorted. There are a few different types of psychotic symptoms, which we will review individually. Hallucinations are hearing, seeing, feeling, tasting, or smelling something that isn't really there. This sensation has no external stimuli. Due to a lack of insight, these individuals think that what they perceive is real. Schizophrenia is usually associated with auditory hallucinations, where the individual hears voices. Tactile hallucinations, like the sensation of bugs crawling on their skin, is usually related to street drugs. Olfactory or smell hallucinations are more commonly seen in the aura before seizures. Delusions are strongly held beliefs that are not based on fact. Due to the lack of insight, trying to convince a psychotic person that their delusions are false is almost impossible, no matter how much evidence you present. Delusions of persecution are the most common type and involve paranoia. These individuals think others are out to get them and are trying to follow them, spy on them, poison them, steal from them, or otherwise harm them. Delusions of grandeur are when an individual believes they have special powers, talents, or intellect. They may think they are famous, have supernatural abilities, or have religious prominence. Other common themes in delusion are guilt, thought control, thought broadcasting, or the belief that others can hear your thoughts, and ideas of reference, belief that people on TV, radio, print media are talking about you. Disorganized speech or thought disorder is random, incoherent speech that may involve repeating phrases or words that sound similar. The patient likely is not aware that their speech makes no sense to others. This is sometimes referred to as word salad. Catatonia is motor hyperactivity with repetitive, purposeless motions, or motor hypoactivity that leads to complete motor immobility and waxy flexibility, where you can move the patient into an odd position and they will stay in that position for hours. It can include a complete disconnect from reality. Here is an example of waxy flexibility. If you moved a catatonic person into this position, they would be able to stay there without moving for hours. A catatonic state should not be confused with cataplexy, which is a type of narcolepsy where people have motor immobility while remaining completely aware of their surroundings. In the previous video in the psychiatry section, we covered mood disorders. There, we briefly discussed mania with psychosis and depression with psychosis. The key difference between schizophrenia and a mood disorder with psychosis is that psychosis in mood disorders is mood congruent. This means that the psychosis is only present during mood episodes and that the psychosis is in line with their mood. So a manic individual may have delusions of grandeur and a depressed individual might have delusions of guilt. You can see here in the top right corner, I give schizophrenia a high yield rating of 3. The high yield rating is a scale from 0 to 10 that gives you an estimate of how important each topic is for the USMLE Step 1 Medical Board exam, based on a number of factors including how often each topic appears on retired Step 1 questions. To learn more about the high yield rating, you can click this orange box here. Schizophrenia is a chronic, progressive psychiatric condition characterized by psychosis and an abnormal interpretation of reality. They have a difficult time functioning in society due to progressive loss of function. Symptoms are categorized into two groups, negative and positive symptoms. Positive symptoms are behaviors or sensations that are not normally present. These symptoms may be related to an excess of dopamine. Examples include hallucinations, delusions, catatonia, and disorganized speech or behavior. Negative symptoms are the absence of normal behavior. Examples include a lack of initiative, diminished speech, disheveled appearance, and flat affect. There used to be specific subtypes of schizophrenia based on what types of psychosis were predominant, but the difference between those types was low yield, and in the most recent version of the DSM, those subtypes have been removed. To make a diagnosis of schizophrenia, you need to rule out other potential causes of psychosis. Street drugs like cocaine or hallucinogens, as well as prescription medications like corticosteroids or anti-Parkinsonian drugs, can cause psychosis. General medical conditions such as stroke, delirium, and dementia also need to be ruled out from the differential diagnosis. Thankfully, these intricacies are a bit beyond the scope of the USMLE Step 1 exam. If the question stem has a clear picture of psychosis, you can safely choose schizophrenia, unless there's a big hint like recent use of cocaine. We will cover treatment for psychosis, like antipsychotics, in a later video in the section. The same group of symptoms are associated with different diagnoses based on their duration. According to the DSM, schizophrenia must have symptoms that persist for more than 6 months. If the symptoms are present for less than a month, you have a different diagnosis. Symptoms of schizophrenia for less than a month is referred to as brief psychotic disorder, and symptoms for 1 to 6 months is schizophreniform disorder. Schizoaffective disorder is a mood disorder in the presence of a psychotic disorder. It can be thought of as schizophrenia plus major depressive disorder or bipolar disorder. Differentiating between schizoaffective disorder and a mood disorder that has psychotic features can be challenging. Thankfully, this is a bit beyond the scope of the exam, but the key is what symptoms are predominant. In schizoaffective disorder, psychosis is the primary symptom, and changes in affect only occasionally occur during psychotic episodes. These individuals will not be depressed or manic in the absence of psychosis. Alternatively, a bipolar person will primarily have mood symptoms and will only occasionally have psychosis during a depressive or manic episode. They will not have psychotic symptoms when they are in a euthymic state or neutral mood. Delusional disorder is characterized by a delusion and the lack of other psychotic symptoms, meaning no hallucinations or thought disorder. These individuals do not have a loss of function and may appear normal most of the time. Unlike the delusions in schizophrenia, the delusions in delusional disorder are usually fixed and non-bizarre. So while the delusion is not based on reality, it is at least plausible. A bizarre delusion would be something like aliens abducted me, while a non-bizarre delusion would be something like my neighbor is trying to kill me, which could potentially occur in real life. The prefix schizo means split. This has unfortunately led to a lot of confusion in the media and general public. Many believe schizophrenia is a type of split personality disorder, also known as dissociative identity disorder, when the two disorders are not related. The split prefix actually refers to the gap between a schizophrenic person and reality. This prefix applies to many of the disorders within the schizophrenia spectrum and other psychotic disorders category, which is a new title added to the latest version of the DSM. Schizoid personality disorder, schizotypal personality disorder, schizophrenia, and schizoaffective disorder all have detachment from reality and or others. These disorders also share features like blunted affect. Individuals with a family history of schizophrenia are more likely to be schizoid, schizotypal, or schizoaffective. As a memory mnemonic, you can think of there being a continuum from schizoid to schizoaffective, where each successive step has most of the characteristics of the previous step plus additional symptoms. The way I remember this is that as the number of letters increases, so do the number of symptoms. Schizoid personality disorder is when a person is very introverted and voluntarily withdraws from social interactions. Schizotypal can be thought of as schizoid symptoms plus magical thinking and odd behavior. Schizophrenia can be thought of as schizotypal symptoms plus psychosis. And as we have already discussed, schizoaffective disorder is basically schizophrenia plus a mood disorder. Schizophreniform, unfortunately, does not fit into this mnemonic. We will cover schizoid and schizotypal in much more detail in a later video about personality disorders. That brings us to the end of this video. If you liked it and would like to make it easier to find other videos from Stomp on Step 1, you can click on this orange box here. Our next video in the series will cover anxiety disorders like OCD, PTSD, and generalized anxiety disorder. If you'd like to be taken directly to that video, you can click on this black box here.